start the discussion, where we will hand it over to the host. So probably the way we want to forum and account, there will be some changes in the between. We may have to discuss to join back at 11:30. And then we'll continue this session at 11:35. We'll log off and join back. And then I want to speak session into probably Rajalakshmi. You want to start off with, and then Major Alita can take the second part. So is that fine with you guys?
Yeah, we'll keep switching. In the,
sitting because, between both of you. Okay, so I will leave it the forum to both of you guys. Yeah, thank you.
We'll take production and work.
So, Major Anisha, we'd like to see your camera on.
Our students want to see you, sir.
We'll be responsible, Alanitya. Atara namgu enu agak bidalla. Gotaita?
Okay. Jai Hind.
Jai Hind, sir.
So, thank you very much.
Okay, firstly, I'll request everyone else to kindly their audios on mute. Not be interruptions, because there's a lot of other noise otherwise. So, can we start?
Yeah, please, sir.
Okay.
Yes, so, I would like to wish a very happy Mother's session. I would like to extend my greetings to all of you, and the name that I can see, Shweta Bhashri, Gunathi Rao, and all of you, after the class, I hand over the mic to my partner. We can all join you.
Okay. So, Namaskara. From the basis. How is it? And a very good, and I hope you are all would listen to some But my projects got stuck, but I was not stuck because I am safe at home. I'm safe and happy at home. And that is how I'm able to interact with all of you lovely people here. And I mean, this has given me an opportunity to, in fact, interact with so many people. As a motivated speaker, as a life coach, I have been speaking with so many people. I have been interacting with so many people, especially during the lockdown, that, you know, and especially to boost their morale and to help them become, you know, more positive. I'm sure that all of you are definitely positive people, but then let's be more positive and let's be more charged up towards achieving, you know, the things that we have always wanted to achieve. In fact, very firstly, I would like to say that most of us probably don't even know what we want to achieve, what we want to do. There's a lot of uncertainty, and especially now, there is even more uncertainty. because we don't know how long the lockdown is going to last. We don't know how the situation is going to be after the lockdown is lifted. We don't know, you know, how, whether things are ever going to get back to normal, like they say. Because the situation has completely changed, my friends. And how many of you here are actually feeling safe at home? And I would like to see some comments so that, you know, I know exactly how you're feeling. So, you know, very firstly, let me see how many of you are feeling safe at home. So all of you, are you all like, you know, safe at home? Are you like happy? Let me see. I want to see some comments. I don't see any comments. You can write in your comments.
Come on, come on. We all need you all to participate. Yes. Write your comments there. We are watching you.
Yes. Yeah, unless.
Come on.
We are going to give you some tips and we are going to give you some great ideas. But then unless, you know what? With all good things, there is one thing. There is one aspect to every good thing. That you need to make some efforts. You need to at least show some eagerness that, you know, I want this. So then, only then you will be able to get it. So if you want some good tips, if you want some great ideas, then you need to write. I'm not going to give it just like that. Yeah. So yeah, it's good to see that yes, some of you are saying that you are safe at home. And Raksha Rao, yes, you're a doctor and you're happy. Yes, that's a very, I'm good to see, so that you are doing a great job, I'm sure. And so all of you, so I hope that you are being safe at home, taking good precautions, etc. But there are some things that we will all need to do to be able to, like I said, not just survive, but thrive. You know, you need to thrive. You need to grow. You need to be more prosperous, abundant. So this is not just about how are we going to get through the lockdown. That is not our destiny. That is not our goal. What we want is that once the lockdown is lifted, we should be friends for our family around us. So, all a state of mind, you approach things, how you look at things. So, there are a few things that cope with things. That you have been doing all this time is really what you have wanted to do. How many of you are actually happy with what you have been doing all this time? So it's like you have been a student, and but even then, some of you are, I can see there are doctors, there are people maybe from some other professions also. How many of you are actually happy and you want to continue with the same thing even after the lockdown is lifted? So I want to know, you know, this is a time for you to think about whether this is actually what you want to do. This is actually what you love to do. Because when you do something from your heart, that is when you will do it well. That is when you'll do it happily. And that is when you'll be able to give your best. Ask me comments. What is this? Are you all like, have you all put off your cameras and gone to sleep or just gone away somewhere? That is
okay. Okay, all of you, stand up right now, please. Yes, do your cameras off, but I can see that. I'm ID professional and happy to proceed with my hobbies. Yes, okay. Now put your hands up, your right hand up, all of you. Right hand up. Yes. Okay. Now give yourself a pat on the back like this. Okay. Yes. Do the cameras off, but I could see through and through. When you are giving a pat on your back is because you have few people in this world who decided to break the shackles, not just survive, but thrive. You have come here on the 100 days
his organizing this webinar to pick up something from here. Now I'll tell you a small story, okay, if I may just tell them quickly. What happened was,
yes,
last month in 2009, I have been speaking at events back to back. There were a lot of offers. Now, there was a prestige invitation from the prestigious Cambridge University where I would go and give a talk. But around the same time, I was working on a film which was produced by Priyanka Chopra. So I couldn't go. So now they asked me, why don't you come and address us through a webinar? Zoom call, what are you right now? Google Meet, WebEx, whatever is convenient to you. I had a very big mental block to technology. I'd heard what seminar is, yes. But a webinar? No way. It was totally alien for me. I'd never heard of what a webinar meant. I said, no, webinar and all, online and all, technology, not my cup of tea. I cannot help it. And I missed out on a very prestigious invitation from, you said it. And I saw you throw your camera off, but I saw you. I could peep. I have a special device over here, where I'll show you, where I can see through and through. Don't get scared, I'm joking. Then what happened? I missed out on this special invitation to go and address Cambridge University. It was a setback, right? So when the virus came about, before the lockdown, there were a lot of talks of Rajni and myself which were planned. We start getting canceled back to back. And how it proceeds. Thought noise talks are getting cancelled. It's unlikely for the next couple of months, but it can be a year also. Now what do? We're in a fix. All our work has come to a standstill. Everything is closed down. It's a complete lockdown. Now what do? I mean, what we did. Okay, can you hear me? My audio isn't very clear, I believe. Can you hear me? All right, okay.
Yeah, we
great.
Can hear you. We can hear you. There's a all little right. disturbance all in right. between. Yeah, but yeah, we can hear you. Yeah.
Okay, all right. Now what happened? On one side, malls, cinema halls, restaurants, coffee shops, theaters, congregations, they were closing down. Companies were closing down. The suffering is they were contemplating of dehiring them. Okay. Big setback, dark times. Now, in darkness, what do? Either you choose to curse the darkness, or you choose to light a candle in the darkness. So that in that darkness, with that candle, you can see whatever you can see, right? I decided to just that along with Rajalakshmi, we said, let us download these video conferencing apps so that we can do it virtually, because the same thing of 2019, Cambridge University, all that I got reminded of. I couldn't go there physically on ground. So now also we can do that. Now, as I told you, I had a mental block to technology. I do not know how to use Zoom. I do not know how to use Google Meet, WebEx, all these apps. Download it, all right. Now, how do I use it? I can reach Bangalore at the airport or station site. How will I Brigade Road, Commercial Street, NG Road, Alsur Lake? How will I reach Alsur Lake from there? I have reached Bangalore. Anybody can reach Bangalore. Now, how do I go from there? There are no cabs, no taxis, no rickshaws, nothing available. So, I got the apps, all right. Now, it took me 2 days of strenuous mental block. towards technology. Because I said, there's no other way. There's no other way. If I am going to be in my house in a lockdown, in my room, which is for our own safety, we must observe the lockdown. We must respect it because the question is not about us only. No. The question is about us being a carrier, which we may not know, affecting somebody else with it. Right? She's saying right. Not you, that's me. I'm talking about her.
Yes, I know.
No, madam,
even I can see that.
All right. Now what happened is, after 2 days of continuous struggle, fighting a battle with my own self, with my inner self, how do I log on to this? Now I learned how to receive a call on Zoom, all right. I had the app with me. Just pressing the link and I don't do anything else. I do not know how to mute, how to put the video off, how to chat, various things I did not know. I learned it on the job. Let me tell you one thing. From the moment I downloaded this app, 2 hours after that, I was on back-to-back webinars, which were all paid webinars. All of a sudden, making money than I did when the lockdown. That's not important. Making business revenue, making money is not very important. No. Not at all. What is most important is, in that 1 month plus time, I was able to, we both in fact, were able to uplift ourselves, especially Rajalakshmi Joshi. She had moments, she's been like incredibly very busy. There are times I cannot partner with her for a lot of webinars. She said, I have this webinar going, that webinar going. But we had so many webinars lined up back to back.
No, I think you, in fact, Major Shah has been conducting also online. So, yeah. I mean, he's not just been doing webinars. It's also like I have had the opportunity to watch him perform live on a webinar. So that was indeed an experience.
But that is not important. Making revenue is not important, ladies and gentlemen. What is actually important is we could come to a position where we could help the daily wage earners. We could help the stray animals who only depend on us. We could do a lot for the humanity. So I say one thing. When I was serving in the army, I served my nation, I served my country, I put life at stake on several occasions, safeguarding our motherland, our national frontiers. I'm fighting the battle again. Because the enemy is invisible. Now, okay, I'll give you a scenario. Imagine this to be God's forbid. Imagine this to be the third world war, okay? God forbid, I'm saying again. Where in your city you see enemy aircrafts coming and flying off your house in the hometown and drop bomb shells and bombarding it? Will we still step out of our house? Garbage. But here we are taking the if we are able to affect something, it's very gratifying. So, in fact, you please be hungry from our side. What happens? We get the blessing. Please, it always. Is watching you, and this was a very important message in the army. In every walk of life, it is important. In the army, we paid special emphasis on it. All right, today I tell people, when we both tell people, that this lockdown, there are people complaining that we've got bored. When will this lockdown end? Come on, have a heart. I am saying if the government decides. See, government has a lot of things to factor as well, right? Not just one thing, a lot of things. And the government decided that they'll open up the lockdown, all right? So the government opens up the lockdown. But the golden question is, the virus opening up? Is the virus taking guarantee? No. Your government open up the lockdown. So I will not sir, we know you are there with us or not. Okay, I think I don't want to bore you with my this thing. Let's hand over the mic trial to Joshi. Yes, please go ahead.
No, I'm sure they were listening to what you were saying, but for some reason, they're not writing it there. Yes.
Okay. Now, so, all of you, of you, laugh. Let me hear you. Put on your audio and laugh. Come on. Very good, sir. Very good.
Say, oh, oh. Let's express all our emotions through our laughing.
I can't hear any laughter. You can unmute yourselves and laugh if you want. Come on, Anjali. Where are you? Come on, be from each one of you. Is that okay? Laugh! Okay, let me bully you to laugh now. Please, you all laugh. See, they're pure laughter, okay? One is genuine laughter, other is art laughter. Right now, I want you to laugh. The artificial laughter. From being artificial, I'll make it real. So laugh like ha 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 ha.
Yeah, if you keep at that, everyone will genuinely start laughing. Into,
that was the whole idea. That's the whole point. Anyhow, now let me translate to you. You go ahead. Let's hear you.
I think that yes, they're all everyone is charged up and woken up now.
Okay, so, all right.
Because a Sunday morning is a little difficult, you know, for everyone to and that also during the lockdown.
Ha, ha, ha.
I mean, everyone. So I'm sure that, you know, yeah. So just saying that there are a lot of interesting snippets and a lot of things to share with everyone, but yeah, you have to keep awake and you have to keep with us. And I think, you know, you need to keep your camera on so that everyone will so that you also can see us and we also can see. And what Major Shah was saying and what I have been trying to tell you is that a lot of things have changed, But then at the same time, the lockdown is not locking in terms of being happy, in terms of, you know, we are just being safe at home. But at the same time, we should be, we can, our thing. And it is a way of, you know, a time for us to, like I was saying, look at things positively, laugh. Like it was just, you know, he just, laugh and be happy and lift your spirit up. It's not difficult. So yes, this situation is not something to laugh about, but at the same time, it keeps trying. You're not going to find any solutions. So definitely the best way to find a solution is to have a clear mind and to be able to think clearly. So like I was saying, review the whole situation. Look at the whole situation, scenarios. Think about, you know, whether you're approaching everything in the right way, whether this is exactly how you should be treating things. So, like, somebody is happy with what they've been all this time, then this is a time for you to, you know, firstly analyze. After you've analyzed everything, then you can rethink whether, okay, like somebody is an IT professional, somebody is a doctor, somebody is a teacher, someone may be a student. So a student may be thinking that I want to do this, you know, after my graduation. So now maybe you may be thinking that, okay, maybe after my graduation, after due to all this situation, maybe this may not be the best alternate. So then you need to rethink. So this is the best time for you to review and rethink the whole situation. Like I give an example. Like when you're taking a picture, you take it from different angles. You know, when you look at, you know, when you take a picture from, say, floor level, when you're sitting on the floor and taking a picture of upstairs, so then the whole thing looks, you know, it looks blown up. When you take a picture from a normal eye level, it looks different. And when you take a picture, like say from, when a picture is taken from a helicopter, or in, we call it as a worm eye view, we call it as a normal eye view level, we call it as a bird eye view. So similarly in life, when you look at any situation, are you looking at it from a worm eye view? Are you looking at it very negatively, or are you looking in such a way that you look at problem and you can't see that? And instead, if you see things from a normal life level, you be able to see that way there, you know, things look absolutely. Keep in touch with the technology, keep in touch with what's happening. And not just that, then, you know, think like there is nothing holding you back. Think like earlier people used to say, think outside the box. Now, the thing is, think like there is no box, isn't it? There is no box holding you back. So what is stopping you? So that is how, you know, like I told you, don't look at things from a worm eye view. A worm, like, just imagine, do you want to be like, you know, looking at things like a worm, or do you want to look at things like a bird, like free, you know, not carrying any luggages, not carrying any burden, not being stressed, just be free like a bird. Think like that. Think happily, think cheerfully, think positively, and you will be able to find better solutions, you know. So like they say, life is beautiful. So be like a bird and don't carry your, you know, stresses, don't carry your pains and negative emotions with you. Carry happiness. That is what you need to take with you all the time. So there is no person in this world who does not go through a difficult situation. It is about how you, each one of you, how you look at a situation, how you treat it, that will make a difference. When you start looking at things differently, you know, you will start, the world will change.
And only you can do that. Yes.
Only you. Who can change your world? Only you. You there. Yes, I'm talking to you. You, only you can change your world. There's no one else. You cannot change a situation. You can change how you look at the situation. You can change how you treat the situation. You can change how you think about it. There's nothing else that you can change. If you think differently, if you change how you think, if you change how you behave, then you will be able to have better control over what is happening around you, because you'll be able to perform better and you will have better control about the entire whatever problems you are facing. So otherwise, how will you, if you start thinking, you know, panicky, then you will never be able to find a solution, because then that clouds your mind. Yes, Vijay Shah.
And also take it like, you know, the earth also at the end of the day needs a break. We have polluted the earth way too much. It needs a breather. So Mother Earth is closed for renovation. There's no pollution happening. We're not polluting the streets. Right? Everything needs a breather, right? The animals today are, you know, out. They're jokes. They're cartoons on social media. They're saying that, oh, humans are inside. And animals are outside and laughing at them, like the way that humans would do it in the zoos. Fight it, guys. And this is a new normal. Let's not wait for things to change. After this lockdown gets over, we will do this and that and that and this. No. Don't wait for things to happen to you. Make things happen. We are responsible for our own actions. Hey, whatever situation we are in, we means all of us together in humanity. We're all joining hands and bearing the brunt, right? Ah, that's a different thing. We're all joining hands after washing our hands, of course. So, but we have to bear the brunt of it together, right? Okay, Dhan, let's hear you. Dhan?
Yeah, I am very much here. Yeah.
So, I asked to laugh that time. Not that.
So when you
I had asked to laugh that time, now you can talk.
Yeah, I am talking, and this is how I talk, and I mean this is how I approach things. I think we wrote on that introduction also that we look at things with a fresh new
exactly.
approach. Yes.
That's the point of anime here. Exactly.
Yes. So when we look at things differently, when we look at things, you know, in a humorous vein, then that is when, you know, everything starts looking brighter. So otherwise you will be like, oh my God, we are all stuck. No, we are not stuck, my friends. We are safe. And in fact, like I said, this is an opportunity for all of us to save a lot of time. Like in Bangalore, oh my God, there's such terrible traffic. Like you want to reach from, say, you know, one place to the other. You want to reach from the airport to Girinagar. Oh my God, it will take you 2.5 hours. So, you know, it's mad. So instead of that, you are so safe and happy at home, and you can spend, you get like 5 hours every day extra. And what are you doing with that much time? Isn't it? So this, look at it as, you know, something like, you know, everybody was saying that, oh my God, I needed some time to maybe, you know, take this course. Somebody else was thinking that I need some time to maybe learn dance. I needed some time to do this. I needed some time to improve my communication skills. So some higher body up there, like, you know, it is like God was like listening to all of us and saying that so many people are asking for so many things. So all of you at one time, I give you one boon that chalo, you are all getting some extra time. Take it and sit at home happily and do what you want. So take it as that. Take it as a collect boon for all of us.
Exactly.
Where, you know, like the earth is also healing. Mother Earth is healing. Mother Earth is people traveling. We don't have people polluting. We don't have, but yes, there are some idiots who still, you know, they want to check if everybody is actually in a lockdown. Who want to the very people who used to say that I don't want to travel, today they want to go out and travel. You know, so people like that. The virus is also spreading, and unfortunately, you know, some of our COVID heroes, some of our doctors, some of our policemen, some of our, you know, the people who are giving their very best services, they are getting affected. So, you know, this is not something to laugh about, but even then, there are such stupid people who are still going out and doing a lot of nonsense, but then at the same time, because most of us are at home, Mother Earth is healing. We all have a lot of extra time on hand. And if you can see, there are so many webinars, there are so many free courses, there are so many nice courses coming up online. So this is a time for each one of you to take time out to use your time well. Don't waste it. Use your time well. You know, spend it on the right things. Like, this is not like you don't need to. A lot of people sent me a list of nice movies to catch up on. Yes, I will go through all those lists, but only after I finish what I want to do, because this is not a holiday. This you know, holiday is like, you know, you take some time off from your daily schedule. This, we don't know when this situation is going to change. So unless we get a definitive cure or a vaccine to this virus, this lockdown or this situation is going to remain the same. So most of us will have to maybe work from home. We will have to reduce the traveling. So we have to look at this situation as maybe the new normal. Maybe not like this. There will be a little traveling outside, but then maybe this will be the new normal. So learn to adapt to it and try to see the best that you can do in this situation. Because this, don't wait for, you know, that someday will come and that day I will be the best. No, that is not how things happen. You have to make the best of what is happening now. If you're doing the best now, are you doing the best now? Are you doing the best you can? Are you the best version of you right now? That is what matters. Because, you know, each one of you gets 86,400 points every morning. Can anyone tell me what that is? I want to see how many of you know what 600 points every morning, some every
points.
Yes. 86,400 something, some points, something. That's you. I mean, who can tell me what they are? Yes, but unfortunately, I can't see who that person is. But one person has said that they are the seconds. Yes, they are the seconds. Each one of us gets 86,400 seconds every morning. So that, I mean, what ask Modali Shah difference one small second or a split second makes for a soldier? How much of a difference
a split
second makes for an athlete? Yes, ask him. It makes a whole hell of a difference. I think he has some very interesting stories to tell you about that.
Okay, I will tell you about the value of a split second. We might think that not possible. I'll tell you. In 2003, I was a young lieutenant in Jammu and Kashmir. They were a friend of mine. He went on a mission. He went on an operation once at night. And he was given the task that there are some Indians hiding heart to neutralize them. This friend of mine set out for the mission. At night, as he entered the hut where the insurgents were supposed to be hiding, he actually came face to face with an insurgent who was holding an AK-47 rifle right at him. This insurgent was holding a rifle at him. He used quick reflexes of mine. Thank you. I thought it's basically I should pause there. I should not go ahead with the story. So I thank you very much. So he came face to face, and there was a split second. Who will pull the trigger first? The insurgent or the army officer or soldier? Now, it so happened in that split second, the army officer happened to pull the trigger first. And the insurgent went and fell on the floor. So he came back after the operation, had a cold glass of water, and he felt so delighted that cold glass of water felt like, I don't know, it felt like the best drink in the world. To me, Ali sir, aaj kya hua pata hai? He told them, cutting a very long story short. Now, that split second was a split second of a lifetime. Just think. Had he been just, it would have cost him his life. That is the reason why we pay so much of emphasis on timing in the army. That is the main reason. And in this lockdown period, no? If you have not learned a new skill, you didn't lack time. No. We definitely lacked discipline. Take precautions. Stay indoors. Remember God. Because as they say, dukh mein samiran sab kare, sukh mein kare na koi. Agar sukh mein samiran sab kare, to dukh kahe ko hoye. Right? Thank you very much for this wonderful comment. So, stay indoors, remember God, and there's nothing, we cannot control the situation. We can definitely control ourselves. And if we remain humorous, if you remain positive, if you remain cheerful, you will only end up building immunity. The immune system will become better. You read me. I don't know your names, I'm referring as read me. If we are sad, upset, demoralized, depressed about it, see, the media will tell us how many people are being tested positive. Unfortunately, how many people are dying. But what they should be telling us, what is not being highlighted, is how many people are actually recovering from this dead virus. The mortality rate of this virus is less than even 3%, actually. I'll tell you what my analysis is, okay? Why is it that there were so many deaths in Italy? Do you think they were careless? No. No one is careless when it comes to life. Let me tell you that. No one. Italy is a country of senior citizens. The average age is from 60 to 80. And this virus is actually affecting the senior citizens the most. India is relatively a young country. The average age in India is more than 50% below 28 years of age. And you know, let me tell you, they say laughter is the best medicine, right? If build up our immunity, you have to continue with our lives. I'll tell you, I was on a national TV panel, you know, I was on a discussion over a month back when the lockdown had just started. I proposed an idea at that time that our healthcare, our police, they have to work. In any case, they have to work, right? Some people don't have the option or the luxury to work from home. Like we do, some of us are, there are some doctors over here. They'll know what I'm talking about. Doctors, the forces people, they're putting their lives at stake for us so that we can be safe at home and work from home. Right? I didn't see in the chat box yes or no. Come on, we want participation here. Only if we get energy from you, we can be able to deliver better. Thank you, Ratha. Yes? Any more? There's one of the doctors left to. That's a very good thing. Yes? I'm so glad. So proud, doctor. Very, very proud. So people don't have this luxury. So let us strengthen the hands, people. See, there's different discriminating and isolating. Let's understand that first. A lot of people say, oh, they're discriminating against. No, 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 discriminating against anyone. It's a very highly contagious disease. Virus. Very dangerous. We got to be careful about it. And let me tell you one more thing, which no one will tell you. The most contaminated is the money, the change, the currency. For example, if you go to a shopkeeper, all right, to buy your big groceries, let's not even talk about that. I'm talking about basic things like bread, which we all eat. You buy bread. A loaf of bread, for example, is costing 30 rupees market. You give the shop 70 rupees. That's all. If you can see tomorrow and how much you can see each day. Absolutely. Thank you very much. So they once were always a soldier. I'm very proud of the fact that I have served the country. And since you mentioned soldiers, I'll tell you one more thing about soldiers. When I was posted in Kohima in Nagaland, I saw on a tombstone engraved over there, when you go home, tell them us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our day. Right? So anyhow, because the farmers are working, they're still plowing the fields. Thank you very much. Thank you, sir. Because the farmers still plowing the fields, we are being able to eat. Now, if it gives you a change of 70 rupees, you will carry it in your pocket and come back home. We might observe the lockdown strictly, all right. But there'll come a moment in 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, and would step out to throw the garbage, to buy our basic daily needs, like groceries, bread. Let me tell you, those 5, 7, 10 minutes are most crucial and the most dangerous. I'll only give you the problem. I'll give you the solution with the problem as well, right? If I only give you a problem, you know the problem. Solution is something which everyone needs. So, those 70s, for example, that you brought home are killing the virus, which you don't know. Very innocently, you bring the virus home. My recommendation is, I'm promoting an increase. Don't use PM or Google. Even better, take his phone number, speak to him, put advance in his account. And with that advance, you order on the phone. I want bread, sauce, mags, soap, What? Go down. Pick it. Come back straight. Why? And water. I would rush me.
I follow very easily, and these are things that you know people don't think about, and most people are not telling you. These are such simple instructions. I mean, so easy for everybody to follow, and if you follow all such precautions, then I don't think, like you know, we have been telling that virus has a big ego. Unless you go out and bring them in, you know, this virus. Right now, there are some 11 different mutations of the virus happening, but even in spite of all of that, that virus will not come inside unless you go out and bring it in. So take care. And okay, now I also want to ask you, you know, if you really think that, you know, this is the time for us to just simply just get through over with this, and is anyone of you here aware of how long it's going to go on? We know there's a very uncertain, there's a very indefinite kind of a situation right now. We don't know how long these lockdowns are going to go on. So that is why there is no clarity about how long this lockdown is going to last. So how many of you here are up for some story about, you know, what we should be doing and how we should be approaching this particular situation? There's a story, a very interesting story. How would you, how many of you want to hear? Unless I see people asking for a story, I'm not going to tell anyone any story. No, like I said, it's not coming free. You have to make an effort. Unless you tell me that you want to hear the story, I'm not going to say it. So, you know, you need to say yes. Only one person has said yes. Thank you. Okay. So this is a very interesting story. Now, all of you are aware, you know, this Indradev is the one who is in charge of the rains and the climate, the weather and everything, right? So once, what happened is Indradev was angry with everybody from Bhulok. So he said there will not be rain for 12 years. For how many years? 12 years, he said there will not be any rain. Then I'm really upset with you all. So nothing doing. And unless Shivji plays his Damru, you know, Shivji plays Damru. So he says there is only one condition, that only when Shivji plays his Damru, then, you know, you will have rain. Otherwise, you will not have rain for 12 years. So everybody was, you know, they started getting panicky. What will we do without rain for 12 years? Like, you can imagine, if there is no rain for 1 year, what happens? So everybody was panicky. 12 years, no rain. What do we do? So then they started, going and, trying to get him to change his mind. Please don't do this, you know. Please give us some mercy. Have mercy on us. So he said, nothing doing. I'm not changing my mind. No rain for 12 years. So then they started thinking about going and approaching Shivji. Shankar Bhagwan, they thought that, okay, if he plays his Damru, so we will have rain. So then why not go and approach him? So then, but Indra Bhagwan also knew that they are going to do this. So he went and told him also that, please, they are going to come and approach you, but you don't do this. So please, I have put this request, but then you please don't listen to them. So then Shivji also thought that, okay, he must be having some reason, so I'll not do it. And so all of these people, you know, people started trying to, they're trying to change, get them to change their mind. But then after some time, gradually, they started, you know, accepting the situation, and they started getting used to it. And they all started looking at it as, okay, whenever the rain comes, we will do whatever we need to do. There was one person who every day, in spite of the fact that whether there was rain, no rain, whatever was the situation, he went along tilling the land, plowing the land, preparing the land, sowing the seeds, everything. He kept on, kept on, kept on. So after 3 years, people started going and asking him, it has been 3 years. I mean, you know that there is no rain and nothing is happening. Why are you doing this? Are you cracked? Huh? What is wrong with you? Why are you doing this? Why are you wasting your time and your energy and all this? So he said that I don't want to forget how to do all of this after 12 years. You know, when there will be rain, what will I do if I forget how to plow the land? What will I do if at that time my tools are not sharp enough? What will I do if at that time, you know, my land is not ready and prepared? What will I do at that time? So I don't want to be caught unprepared. That is why I will keep improving my efficiency. I will keep on with this. I still have the hope that, you know, Shankar Bhagwan will grant us this boon and he will be merciful enough to take us out of this situation. So they are also in the Malla Goidaima. You know, they went. And Parvati Mata was watching all of this. So Parvati Mata, she showed, she told Shivji, she told Shankar Bhagwan, see, look at this man. Look at how persistent he is. But he does have a point. What will you do if you forget how to play the damru? Are you sure that after 12 years, you will not forget how to play the damru? What will you do then? So he said, how can that happen? I am not going to forget how to play the damru. How can that ever happen? Of course, I will not forget. So then she says, how can you be so sure? This is, of course, that will not happen. But then somewhere, you know, like they say, dil ke kisi kone mein, you know, he started thinking that what if really I have forgotten how to do it? So then he picked up the damru and he tried it. And what happens is, when he tried playing the damru, you know, started raining. And in this entire situation, only one person benefited. So you all can imagine who. That was that one person who was unmindful of the fact that whether there is lockdown, no lockdown, he went on enhancing his skills. He went on improving himself. He went on sharpening his tools. He went on with the same thing as if everything was normal. So that one person, he was the one who benefited. So doesn't this tell you something? What does it tell you? That you never know when this lockdown is going to get lifted. What will you do if tomorrow somebody comes up with a vaccine and tells you that, okay, from tomorrow there is no lockdown. But then, even though there is no lockdown, when you step out of your house, everything will have changed. The way you visit a mall, the way you go and watch a movie, the way you go to a restaurant, the way you go shopping, everything is going to change, my friends. So whatever business you may have been in, whatever you may have been studying for, everything will have changed. But will you be ready for it? You there, will you be ready for it? So if you are caught unawares, if you are caught unprepared, don't be in that situation. Be smart, my friends. Be smart. So take the best, make the best of this opportunity that you have. Like I said, in Bangalore, traveling from one place to other is like, it is, you know, I know what a nightmare it is. Each one of you knows. So you are right now having this boon where you don't need to travel anywhere. And from your home, you can sit and enhance yourself, improve your skills. And this is, you know, so that whenever this situation changes, I'm not saying it will go back to normal. No. Whenever the situation changes, you will have a lead. You will have an edge. And right now, from the comfort of your home, you can even start a business. You can maybe start making YouTube videos. We see so many YouTube videos. How to do this, how to do that. So you may have some skills. So make a video, put it up online. You don't know how to make a video? You have been watching so many videos. Why don't you put up that question? How to make a video? I'm sure that if you look, you will find somebody who must have put up something saying how to watch a YouTube video also. So you, there is everything you want on YouTube, on online basically. Everything is there. So go look for it. Find out how you can make the best of the situation. Think like there is no box. Go out and do whatever you want to achieve. Whatever you want to achieve. There is nothing that is stopping you. You can start a new business. You can think of a new business. The minute the very first step towards achieving something is dreaming, thinking that you can do it. When you think that you can do it, you set into motion a whole lot of things. Like, then that is when you will start thinking how to do it. Then when you start thinking how to do it, and then when you actually take action, that is when you will actually be able to achieve it. So otherwise, if you don't even think about it, how will you ever achieve it? So it is like making a dish. To make a dish, what do you need? You need to first know what you want to do. Secondly, you need to know how to do it. And the third thing is, you need to do it. Otherwise, like you say, you will have a khayali pulao. You don't want a khayali pulao. You want a real thing happening. You want to achieve something. So do it. Think about what you want to do. And then find the steps. Set yourself some goals. Do it. Yes. Go ahead and do it. So firstly, think about what you want to do. So use the time to make the best of what you can do. So be the best version of you. You, yes. Don't compare yourself with somebody else. Because that person... Only you. So you, only you will know what you can do. What is your best version? Because somebody else may have some other skills. If tomorrow Sachin Tendulkar tries to go and become an F1 racer, I don't think that he would have been a great F1 racer. Just because, you know, it's like he will say, I want to become Michael Schumacher. He would not have been able to do that. Michael Schumacher might not have become a great cricketer. So you have to see what is you, what is it that is the best version of you? You, yes. So you find out what you are capable of doing. And then find out, yes, identify your potential. See what you are good at. See what makes you happy. See what, you know, what you love to do. Because then when you do something that you love to do, then you will do it the best. And be the best version of you that will be the best that you can do, that you can achieve. And, you know, I think even Major Shah also will be able to tell you. I'm an architect, but I also have been doing so many other things. Like, I write a lot. I've been on television debates. And I am a motivational speaker. I'm into a lot of social activities. And Major Shah, he has not only been an Indian Army veteran, he has been into the corporate world. He's from IIM Calcutta. So he has been, heading corporate companies also. And then he's been into theater also. He's been into acting also. And now he's a fantastic motivational speaker. So a lot of things are possible. So Major Shah will tell you, how much percentage of your mind, of your brain, of your capacity people have been actually using. So think about whether you are using the full potential, whether you are using the best version of you. Yes. Are you doing that? Major Shah, please tell them how much of your mental capacities people are using.
All right. Okay. I will not switch on the video, I imagine, because in the new you people have not switched on your videos. Neither have you been chatting with us, neither you putting comments. So why should I put on my video, right?
So then maybe then I should.
There. I had a software install. I saw you. Who I'm talking about, that person knows. I will not take the name, but I saw you just now behind the camera. Got you. Okay, fine. I get it. Why you are not on the video? I got the answer now. I don't want to embarrass you. All right. Okay. Now you better listen up, huh? It's okay. Whatever you, that's okay. But listen to this. Abraham Lincoln. We all know his story. Every time he failed, right? But he rose from the ashes and to the height that he reached. We'll talk about him as well. But before that, let me talk about Thomas Alva Edison, Isaac Newton. All right? How much percentage of the brain did they use? Let's see the answer in the chat box. Come on, all of you.
Take a guess and write. Come on, quickly.
Come on. I'm not presented like here in the man. Yeah. You're not there with us.
Come on, no one can even guess. Come on, nobody's going to get punished for writing something wrong. At least you could be close to the answer maybe. Come on. Let's see. Okay, one person has answered. Okay, let us see some more
only
responses.
One person, all the participants. Yeah, I don't trust simple. They don't want us to proceed.
Okay, I can see some responses now. One person says, Prakriti says 2%. Gurudat says 5%.
Okay.
And AK says around 40%. And Dhananjay G says 30%. And Aishwarya says 22%. Okay. Gunavati says 10%.
I love that guess. I love that guess. It wasn't 20 or 25. I love the guess. It wasn't 20. It wasn't 25.
Anju says 6. Anju says 6. Okay, so quite a few guesses there right now. So maybe you can now break the suspense. 12%, okay.
Okay, let's see. You take it forward. You take it forward, Raja.
You are going to tell them. You are going to tell them. Come on. Okay, so out of all, I mean, so many people have made so many guesses. But yes, I think the person who is closest would have to be Anju. Because, yes, we use roughly, slightly, not we, the geniuses that we have all known about, most of them, have used less than 7% of their brain capacity, of their potential. 7%. Yes, you heard it right. So just imagine what exactly is the, you know, what exactly our mind is capable of. Yes. I mean, no, it's just that you are not, it's not like you are not 1% of them. It's that you are, you know, you've bounded yourself by some limitations. You, like, the very first thing is that when you said that you are not even 1%, that is means that you are binding yourself that, okay, I cannot reach up to that level. No, you can. You start using your mind better. You start using your brain better. You start using more of it and then see that you'll be able to perform better. The very first thing that stops you is when you say, I can't. Okay, that is the first thing. you tell yourself, when you say, I can do it, or when you say, I can't do it, you are actually telling your own brain. You're telling your brain, you're giving it an instruction that I can't do it. So when you say, I can't do it, the brain thinks that, okay, I can't do it. You know, it's like, see, when you take a child to a doctor, so it's like, you know, about this injection, most people, like most children, even grown-ups also are so scared sometimes of even taking a small injection. So it's just a matter of, you know, everybody knows that it's just going to be a small prick, but then some people are so scared of it. So, you know, the doctors, they divert their mind. There are the pediatricians, they divert the mind and they make, make sure that, you know, their mind is somewhere else. And they won't even realize. So that pain, do you think that a soldier may have some different kind of take more pain? Do you think a mother has some different kind of a body structure where she is able to sustain so much pain? So it is because, you know, you have to, you, yes, thank you so much. I am also a proud mother. So it is like each one of us is capable of so much more than we actually do. So it is just that, you know, we have ourselves put limitations. So there is a whole lot that we can all achieve if we start thinking that we can do it. So there is no limitation to what our mind can achieve. So the very first thing that, you know, in any situation, if you feel that, okay, this is something I can't do, immediately change it and think that, okay, take a deep breath, meditate, and think that, okay, I can do it. Think, the first thing that you'll have to change is to think that you can do it. When you change from the can't to the can, it's just a simple thing. When you change that, you change your entire world. You change the entire situation. So that is the easiest and the most simplest trick to do it. So just think that you can do it. That is the very first thing to do. Whether you want to do a startup, whether you want to give an exam, even during an exam, when you forget something, I'll give you a trick here. How many of you are ready for a trick to know what to do if you forget something during an exam? I'll give you a very important trick. No one else will ever give you this trick. How many of you want to know? I want to see if you want to know this trick, only then I will tell you what to do. It's a very simple trick. Okay, so I can see some responses here. So, okay, I give it to you. When you are stuck in an exam, you know, trying to figure out what might be the answer, you know what you need to do? You just close your eyes, meditate, concentrate, and imagine that you are asking your teacher or somebody trustworthy who might be knowing that answer. Imagine that you are asking them what the answer would be. And you'll be shocked that that person might actually tell you the answer. Because you might have heard this thing during some class. You must have read it somewhere. You must have heard about it somewhere. In your subconscious, you know, that answer will be there. You just need to bring it out from your subconscious. So you ask a person, you ask maybe your teacher, that what is the answer to this question? But you have to go deep down into yourself. You need to concentrate, meditate, ask yourself. ask the teacher maybe, what is this, what is the answer to this question? That person will tell you. You want to try, you can try it. Because that, see, this is like, you sometimes you have misplaced your keys somewhere. And you are not just not able to find it. So what do you do? Sometimes all you need to do is, you know, and then at some other time when you're not even thinking about it, you suddenly remember that, oh, I had put my keys there. I forgot about it. So your mind knew about it, but it didn't tell you at the right time because you did not look in the right place. That subconscious part of your mind knew this answer, but you did not look for it in the right place. In the right place. See, the right side of your mind is the, it is a little intuitive. It is a little, it is about music, about art, and you know, it has a lot to do with intuition. So use the right side of your brain, and that will, that is the lock to the lock and the key to your subconscious. And that will tell you that this, you know, this is where you placed your key. This is the answer to your question. So this will, you know, this is the easiest and simplest way. Just go into your subconscious and find it out. That is the simplest way. So this is how, you know, you yourself don't know the capacity. You don't know what is the, what you can achieve. So you think that you have forgotten. It is, you have not forgotten it. It is in a different place in your memory. You just have to go and find it. So if you have attended that class, how is it that you could have forgotten it? No, you have, you definitely know it. It's just that it is stored somewhere, some place deep in your brain. You have to access it. So access your brain properly. Use your brain properly. You don't know the potential of your own self. Use it properly and nothing can stop you. So there is no difference between you and what you think is an achiever of or your idol. The only difference is that they think that they can do it and they take suitable action to do it. Yes, just thinking that I can do it will not help. You need to take suitable action also to do it. So then do it. Take action. Think about it. Imagine that you can do it and take suitable action and you will definitely achieve whatever you want to achieve. So I think, you know, we have spoken quite a bit and
I think our students are really enjoying you, both of your, you know, the motivations. Okay. Especially a lot of students, you know, I see some students, 7th standard student, 8th standard student, some are doing a degree, some are doing engineering, some are doing, you know, second PU, right? So the varied, different classes of students are there.
Okay.
I think it's really important that, you know, whatever you are saying is absolutely right. And especially the three concepts that you spoke about, right? In terms of plan and then, you know, do the right things and then understand how to do it, right? So, and then execute it. So yes. The multiple stages
Yes. That
involves, I think that's very, very important for everyone, including all of us, right? Not only as students. So even in corporate Yes. World or whatever the work that we do, it's important Yes. That we plan it out and then understand what skills that we have and then build on top of that, right? So that's very important. So that's one of the things that's Yes. Lacking in some of the corporate world also, that, you know, they may be good at something, but because of situations, they continue to do whatever they're supposed to be doing it without understanding what their capacity is. And one, example I wanted to quote here is, without mentioning any name, there are a lot of IPS officers recently. One of the great IPS officer today, has left his job to do something better, right? That's something really motivating for all the people in this world in terms of identification of what they are the best and how can they bring in change in the society, right? I think both of you are really a wonderful job.
Thank you,
Major Shah and Rajalakshmi. Really,
sir, thank you.
And I wanted to on behalf of discussion class, I wanted to thank both of you to extending your support and motivating the students. Before we close up, I wanted to ask a few questions from the students if they have any. Either they can put it in group chat, or they open up the video and they can ask directly. I think it's an opportunity to speak to both of you directly. I know it's not possible to meet in person, but at least virtually we are connected through web conferences. I request students, if you have any questions, it's an opportunity to speak to both of the best motivational speakers available in here. So it's an opportunity to ask any questions if you have. So I will open up the forum for the question and answer. Gunavati, you can speak directly. Yeah. Gunavati, it's an opportunity to speak to the Major and Rajalakshmi. Yeah. Spandana, you have any questions? Spandana is one of our youngest student in our DC. Spandana, have any questions? Okay, Spandana is saying she doesn't have any questions. Okay, Anju is saying he enjoyed it. Gunavati says thank you. Guys, I have one request. Can we all the students put video on?
Okay, I am getting some private requests also.
Okay.
So you could actually write to everyone, or you could actually say it on camera also. That would also be good. But yeah, so without postponing, how to make good time management schedule. Okay, so when you are speaking about a management schedule or about time management, right? Now I have seen that a lot of people, most of us, we have different concentration spans. So some people are able to focus for a shorter span of time. We are not able to actually concentrate. So each one of us knows what is our best capacity. So if you feel that a particular situation, say as a student, if you are not able to concentrate or sit for say half an hour at one stretch, take it a little lesser, make it say 20 minutes, or and then take a break of say a few minutes and then sit back again, but make a schedule and stick to it. Like I said, you have to make your mind stronger. You have to stick to your decision. So when you say you want to do it, do it. So make a schedule. And within that, include, say, maybe exercise and include a little bit of relaxation. Take time to do hobbies. That is also important. So when you do all of that, you keep your mind fresh. And very firstly, when you're doing something that you enjoy, when you do something that you like to do, you won't feel burdened. When you do something happily, you don't feel burdened. When you do something unhappily, you feel, oh no, I have to do this. Then that is a huge burden on your head. So take it in a very different way and create a schedule where it is, that this is a workable schedule. So then you'll be able, and then actually stick to it. Now, every day we have been doing so many webinars. We are actually dressed up completely. See, I'll show you, I'm dressed up completely. All right. And I sometimes even put on my perfume to make myself feel good. It's like you need to feel good and nice. So you follow your schedule, follow your routine. make a schedule and follow it. And at the end of the day, review whether you have actually stuck to whatever you wanted to do and whether you actually have been able to achieve whatever you wanted to achieve every day. Every day is a new challenge. Every day is a new battle. Every day is something that you can do something good. So yeah. Live in the now and do the best that you can do.
Yeah. Excellent. Excellent. Madam, there is one more question. Prakriti is asking, mediating in exam hall feels shy. How to come out of it?
Mm-hmm.
In exam hall, she feels shy. How to come out of this?
You feel shy in an exam hall. I'm thinking that maybe she feels that somebody may feel intimidated or feel scared about, how to approach the exam. So like I said, the first thing is you think that you can do it. Like I was telling you some time back, use the right side of your brain. Tell yourself before you approach the exam hall that today I am going to rock it. I am going to be a champion. You know what they say, like when you go to an interview, before you go to an interview, like you sometimes you go there and see so many different people are there. And you feel, oh my God, I am never going to be able to achieve this. You know, there is one small trick that you can do to improve your confidence. What you can do is, say if there is a restroom, a washroom in that, say maybe in that office, go there and look at yourself in the mirror and say, yay, I'm going to do it. I'm a champion. And immediately, you will feel that entire situation change. You know, when you start doing that, the situation, your mind itself will tell you that, yes, you are a champion. You need to tell your mind, you need to tell yourself that this is, I am a champion. Tell yourself, I am a champion. Say, tell yourself right now, I am a champion and I am going to do it. I am going to rock it. So then you will be able to do it. You will be able to do it better. And you will be able to, you will not feel shy. You will not feel intimidated. So like we say, remember God, remember your gurus and bow down to them and tell them that please help me remember everything that I have learned and that I may be able to remember everything at the right time. Remembering the right thing at the right time is very important. It is a curse if you are not able to remember the right thing at the right time.
Yeah, very.
So tell yourself that I am going to remember the right thing at the right time during the exam. Before you enter the exam hall, tell yourself.
Excellent. Excellent, ma'am. Ma'am, there is one more question probably to Major Shah. Concentration, because I thought being in army, it's important to maintain constant concentration. How you guys manage?
Absolutely. That I will tell you. Especially I'm afraid I want to switch on my video camera. Actually, I really mean to, but I don't know what's happening. I'm trying to switch it on and it's some blur figures coming. I think my phone camera was spoiled, so I don't know what has happened. So I will just speak. Consider that I am wearing a mask and I am speaking, right? Okay. In the army, when we take an aim at a target, at that time, only you, your weapon, and where you are aiming, that's it. You can't be seeing anything else, otherwise you will miss the target. And that precision is very important. Similarly, when you play games, when you play sports, when a footballer runs with a football, goes to score a goal, there is nothing he is thinking or seeing, just he, the football, his goal. A cricketer, when he's batting, while batting, you cannot afford to think of home,
personal problem, the domestic problem, national problem, the care problem. No. All you got to focus is on the ball. Bowler, when he's bowling, should focus on getting the wicket, right? So it's very important to have that focus. Now, how do you achieve that? The best way is through meditation, through yoga. In the army, it's compulsory to do yoga meditation. It is compulsory. So best way is give yourself some time every morning when you follow routine, do yoga, do meditation. Meditation is the best way to actually improve your mental health and your concentration. Okay. Hope I've answered.
Yeah, thanks a lot, sir. AK, you got the message
Okay. I just wanted to add one thing. When you were talking about feeling shy, actually, I think she meant to ask that, you know, it feels shy to actually sit in the exam hall and meditate. When I say meditate, you know, you don't need to go to an entire extensive process. All you need to do is, you know, when you meditate on a regular basis, what will happen is you will not actually need, say, maybe 10, 20 minutes to actually sit and meditate. You just need to close your eyes, go think deep into your, you know, self. You can take 2 minutes to just close your eyes and, you know, just pray and meditate and then tell yourself that I'm going to remember this. So there's nothing to feel shy about it. Everybody does that. You know, everybody does that. So, and you don't need to feel shy because when you start thinking about what others will feel about you, what others will say about you, you know, then that exactly holds you back. That is holding you back. Don't feel shy. Don't think about what others will think. Those people are not going to come there to help you if you get lesser marks. They are not going to come there if you don't do well in your exam. So you may not even meet them ever again in your life. So how do they matter? What they feel, what they think doesn't matter to you. What you do matters. So don't feel shy. So what you need to do is you concentrate, go deep down into your own mental level. You meditate and you tell yourself that I am going to be the best that I can ever be during this exam. So that I think that is what she meant when she spoke about feeling shy. Yeah. So now anyone else has questions, you can go on.
Students, if any more questions from you guys to Major Shah and Rajalakshmi ma'am? Okay, I think if there's no questions, probably, you know, any last note from both of you, sir and ma'am, before we give a vote of thanks.
I think someone last is asking question. About mobile addiction. Someone is asking about okay. mobile
Excellent.
Addiction.
Excellent.
Major Shah, would you want to answer that? Major Shah, are you there? Would you want to answer about mobile addiction? Okay, before that, there is one more question about how to control nervousness. Like I just said just a minute ago, that, you know, don't be mindful about what others feel about you, what others think about you. That is when you start feeling nervous. You start feeling conscious about somebody's watching, somebody's judging you. Don't worry about what others are thinking about you. That makes you nervous. You know, you think as if, you know, just like they say, like dance like no one is watching, sing like no one is watching. So perform your duty like no one is watching and be true to yourself. Like you have to be like integrity is also when you do the best or when you do the right thing, even when no one is watching. So that nervousness comes from the fact that you feel that you're being judged. So who are all of those people to judge you? Whatever they feel, like someone else may, you may think that, oh, maybe they will laugh at me or whatever. Like I said, you don't know. Maybe you'll never ever meet those people ever again. You say if they are your classmates, your colleagues, you don't know what is going to happen after 5 years. You may be in a different place. They may be in a different place. So what you do right now matters. What they think about what you're doing does not matter. So do what you need to be doing, not what they think or what they feel that you should be doing.
Okay, right? Excellent. Yeah.
Yeah, about mobile addiction, Major Shah, what do you want to say?
Yeah. See, it's about mental health, actually, you know. And in this lockdown period, it's perfectly fine. It's not, I would not call it addiction. Like, you know, oh God, again, my camera, I'm trying to see it on, but it's not coming on. Anyhow.
Okay.
My laptop is packed up, all right? I am on back-to-back webinars. I have to use a mobile right now. Even at this point of time, my phone is on charge. Because there's no back.
Yeah, I guess what he wants to say is that right now, in this situation, yes, we are all using a lot of our mobile phones and our laptops, our iPads. So I wouldn't really call it an addiction. But in any situation, whatever it may be, addiction is what? When you don't have control over your usage about a particular thing. So you don't have control. So that, you know, that ultimately it comes back to mind control. So whatever may be the addiction, ultimately it comes to
control mind control.
Yeah, when you are able to communicate properly, you know, are you able to, hello, are you there?
Yeah.
Yeah, please go ahead. You were saying, and you were talking about mobile addiction.
So sorry, I'm having some network issues. So I just heard you say that I don't have control over my network. Hey, I heard you say I logged in for a brief while, could control over my network.
No, I was not talking about you. I was talking about in general, when people don't, any addiction is about not having, you know, it's about mind control. And right now I said that everybody
is... I'm just joking.
Okay. Yeah, you don't have control over your network. That is something you can't do. You can, like in spite of the bad network, the fact that you are so happily and so enthusiastically addressing all of this is, it shows your mind control. So you need that presence of mind. Yeah, please go ahead, Major Shah. Please.
But yeah, I'm done. I was just saying this only.
Yeah.
So no, you I think were talking about.
Yeah, there is one question on how to motivate ourselves and to motivate others. I think Rajalakshmi, you want to take that question? I think you already answered this in the past. You want to once again reiterate to Bhargavi. Bhargavi has a question. She runs a discussion class center in her home in Bhatkal Karnataka, and she has a lot of 10th standards SSLC students for whom she conducts peer learning classes and at home. Mm-hmm. And last 3 years she's been doing this, and you know, we have seen excellent results. And because of the lockdown, the students, you know, we requested them not to, you know, assemble at one place. And then, you know, she has been helping the students. She's also a student, by the way. She's a degree student. And she's helping 10th standard students to kind of motivate them and then calling them and then giving some assignments and stuff like that. So she's asking, you know, how to keep motivating them in this kind of lockdown, right? So because she runs a discussion class center and now students are not coming, right? It's important sometimes when we, the teacher doesn't connect with the students, it is going to be a little disconnected or a disjoint situation. So she was asking your input on that.
You want to take that, Major Shah?
No, you get that. Okay. The voice was speaking, actually, I couldn't really get that. Ha ha ha.
Okay.
Ha. First laugh.
Ha ha ha.
First laugh and then answer. No, louder.
Okay.
No, first.
Okay. Okay. The question is about how to motivate yourself and then how to motivate others. Yeah, so that is, I mean, the sequence is perfect. You know, first you motivate yourself and then you can motivate others also. So firstly, to motivate yourself.
Louder, like, first. Louder.
I think that you louder. Are the best person. I think you are the best person to answer this question then.
Laugh like ha 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 like that. Okay, now then.
Yeah, so firstly, motivate yourself and then you can motivate others. In fact, the best thing would be if, you know, people are motivated looking at you. That, you know, they themselves would feel that, okay, this is something that I must also do.
But for motivating yourself, you'll have to laugh louder, no?
So, you do it. You start it first. You do it. By, just by you bullying somebody, you cannot motivate them. Come on. You do it first. You tell them how to do it. And then, you know, you can actually demonstrate also. Come on, Major Shah, come on.
Right. I really want to put a camera here, but there's really,
I think we have some network issue at Major Shah's side. Whenever he speaks, it's not audible. I'm not sure if it's the same case with others also.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, so what I was saying is motivate yourself first and then you can motivate others. Excellent. And like the very first thing is about your own mind. So take away those boxes. No, anything that is holding you back. Just think that you can do it, whatever it may be. The when you start thinking that you can do it, you can do it. So, and you know, you have to read a lot of motivational stuff. You need to keep motivating yourself by listening to positive thoughts. And you know what? Have you ever thought about it? Like, how can you get rid of darkness? There is no other way to get rid of darkness other than introducing light. Like, you know, if there is darkness, like you light a candle, you put in light, you switch on the light. Light is the only answer to darkness. Similarly, to negative thoughts, you cannot do anything by saying, I want to get rid of negative thoughts. The only way of getting rid of negative thoughts is by bringing in positive thoughts. So keep bringing in positive thoughts, positive affirmations. You know, we used to have these things in the school saying that I will not, you know, misbehave in class, or I will not come to class without doing my homework. So all those things, you know, you keep saying, when you keep saying the same thing to yourself, that goes into your subconscious. So keep affirmations, saying that I will be the best version of me. I will say, maybe you want to do a startup, maybe you want to start some classes, you want to motivate 10 people today. Say that you're going to do it. So keep telling yourself that you're going to do it. Then you will be able to do it. So, and similarly, and then by your own behavior, by the change, by the shift in your attitude, others also will be able to see it, and they themselves also will feel motivated to do it. Tell them your examples. Tell them how you came out of a difficult situation and you were able to overcome it. So smart people are not those who don't make mistakes. Smart people are those who make mistakes and learn from it. And even smarter people learn from other people's mistakes. So, you know, motivate yourself first and then motivate others by using your stories, by telling them how you overcame some failures, how you went through difficult times and how you overcame them and how you are able to achieve something. Then you will be able to motivate them also. Students, you'll be able to motivate them.
Yeah, excellent. That's really good point, ma'am. Any questions, Bhargavi, AK, Spandana, Gunavati, Anju, Aishwarya?
Let's hear from Vandana. Vandana, come on. Let's hear from you. You're the youngest participant. Come on, Vandana. We got to have a question from you, Vandana. Come on.
I don't see Vandana here.
I think she had a class. She just a few minutes back she left it. So what is happening is the schools and colleges also having classes on Sundays to cope up with this new way of learning. Even Gunavati had the classes in the morning itself. Right, so it's a change, a complete changeover from traditional way of teaching. Right, so earlier we used to go to schools and colleges, and now everything is online, and they are adjusting to the new environment the way we are adjusting ourselves. Especially some people, those in a corporate world, they're used to it, but for students, everything taking online classes is a very, very new concept. And they're trying to cope up with that as well, right? So that's very important. A shift in the paradigm that we are seeing. And luckily, we have a digital skills like Zoom or WebEx or Teams or whatever, right? There's a lot of apps available, which can really help us in terms of connecting with students to teachers. And that's what I think probably Bhargavi will also explore with your students in terms of, having, Zoom app in your students' mobile and then connecting them on a daily basis and start giving some assignments and start evaluating them and giving motivation to them to engage in terms of whatever ma'am just now mentioned, giving example, positive examples of yourselves, how you succeeded and how you are using your digital skills, digital platforms to, get yourself, comfortable with the new world of living, right? So that way you can also pass on the same message to your students as well. Okay, I think I want to take a break here unless there is any further questions from the students. And personally, Major Shah and Rajalakshmi Vidam, really nice talking to both of you. We are really honored both of you being on paneled on this webinar session to addressing most of our students. And most of these guys are studying in varied classes, SLC, BUC, engineering, and some people or medicos as well, and some of them are professionals, some of them are running preschools in Bangalore, and some of them are doctors, and some of them are IT professionals, and we have a pool of 8,000 working professional across the world, which our teacher Gopal Krishnamurthy has created through this informal education called discussion class. And really honored and thanks to both of you spending precious 2 hours of your time. And on behalf of Discussion Class Association and on behalf of all the students, I wanted to thank you from the bottom of my heart. And thanks a lot for both of you to motivating the students. Thanks a lot.
In fact, every time I speak with somebody like this, I myself also learn a lot, and I myself also feel motivated every time I speak. And I'm sure Major Shah also will have some. And Major Shah, thank you for motivating us And I mean, every time I listen to you, I also feel motivated. Thankful to you for every time, you know, every time that you motivate us.
Yeah, real thank you to you, sir.
Thank you. Yeah.
Thanks a lot. Thanks to both of you.
I really enjoyed this webinar. Really, thank you very much.
And yeah, thanks a lot to all the students, you know, who are joining in. And I'm sure, you know, this is a platform where students also, you have your own students base. Please, you know, this is an informal peer learning platform. Please circulate to your students and ensure whatever the message that you got from both of our, you know, motivational speakers, please pass on to your students and then let the knowledge percolate and everybody adapt to the new world. And last but not the least, please, all of you be safe. Follow the protocol set by the government, local authorities, and you know, wherever you are living in. I know a lot of people are joining from multiple districts and, you know, different parts of Karnataka and then some parts of India as well. So request all of you to follow whatever the protocol being set by local authorities and the government, and let's all of us support. And as a an organization, sir and ma'am, just wanted to update, we have been supporting a lot of you know, the migrant laborers in and around where our registered office is there. We donated more than 300 kits, grocery kits, to people who are working.
Oh, wow.
And then 200 N95 masks to Corona Warriors. We have given to Superintendent of Police, KSRP.
Wow.
And then 200 face visors we have donated. And some sanitizers and masks, local police stations we have donated. We are trying to do whatever best possible through our organization. And also, you know, thanks to both of you guys, you know, motivating through a webinar to our students as well. Yeah. Okay.
Has been a real pleasure. Yeah.
Thanks a lot to both of you, and thanks to you students for joining in. I will share the record and link. You know, probably if you want to share with your students, you can go ahead and share. You know, this important session, and stay safe, stay healthy, and stay positive. We will come back, and you know, we'll beat this corona for sure with all the support from all the Corona Warriors. And thanks a lot to all the Corona Warriors. And happy Mother's Day, and salute to you, sir. Thanks a lot. Salute to you.
Yes. Salute to you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you so much, everybody.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.